So we have a share price. So this is the price. And this is time. So it'll be, you know, going up and down. Something like that. Of course, it could be something entirely different. This is just one potential share price, the kind of thing that can happen. So this is a quick introduction to what a call option is. So what is a call option? Since we're going to be pricing them, we might as well, you know, find out what we're talking about. So a share has a price. How much it costs. It also has a dividend and other characteristics, but primarily from our point of view here, the share has a price. An option I'll focus on a call option. A call option is the option, I suppose I'll say what it is. A call option is an option to buy a share at a given price, at a given time. So this gives you the option to buy a share. If the call option is an option on a share, it could be on other instruments, but we're just focusing on a share and on call options in this video. So it gives you the option to buy a share at a given price on a given day or at a given time. So what that means, one more thing. So the given price is called the strike price. So let's say, I'll write that down. Is called the strike price. He's putting it in capitals for emphasis. So say you have bought a call option on, say, using this time scale, and I've decided to buy a call option at that price. Well, if I have the option to buy, so I'll just give a number there, so say that's 40, that's 30, and it doesn't start at 0, it starts at 20. So at the time, or at the relevant time for our call option, the share price is actually lower than our option price. So if that's the case, you don't, you let the option expire. I mean, why would you buy a share for 40 euro when you could buy it for 30? So it's roughly, at the time in question, the share price was roughly 30. So the option protects you from the downside. If the basically if the share price is to collapse, then you don't lose money because you didn't actually buy, you don't own any of the share. You just have an option to buy it. So it protects you from downside risk. At the same time, if, say, the share price had gone up, so say the date had been here, and you had the option to buy it at 40, well, now the share price has actually gone up to 50. So if something costs 50, and you have the option to buy it at 40, of course you would. So in those cases, when the share price is higher than your strike price, you'd exercise the option. That means, you know, you would buy the share at 40, your strike price. So that's the mechanics of Black Scholes. And we're being, this is just a quick introduction of the main idea. So we've only talked about call options. Call options are, it gives you downside protection. The other one is called a put option. So there you're short the share. So there you're selling, you have the right to sell a share at the strike price. And so you'd exercise it if the share price was lower than your strike price. So if you think that the share is going to go down, you'd buy a put. And finally, the example I'm giving here is known as a European option. So that has a specific fixed date. So you say, I have the option to buy the share on October 1st, 2015, say. And I'd probably, it would be at 12 o'clock. Then what the price is, that's the only time you're able to exercise your option. Another type of option is an American option. So an American option would be, say you have an American option up till this date. An American option would let you exercise the option at any time up to that date. So if the share price happened to go up halfway through the interval, you'd be able to exercise your option, buy the share price, or you buy the share at only 40, and then you'd have made money. So that's known as an American option. So say you bought an American option up till that date, well then you'd have to decide, oh, it's now above my strike price, do I cash in, or do I wait for it to go up further? That's standard trading issues. So the main focus on this short series of videos is on how you can actually implement the Black Scholes model easily within Excel. So that's what we're going to be looking at in the next few videos.